Today I want to talk about limb length discrepancy. This is also called short leg syndrome, and it's exactly what it sounds like. One leg is shorter than the other, and this can lead to a number of different problems. Commonly, it will cause back pain or hip pain, sometimes knee pain. So if you're someone who has a history of back pain, for example, you've had x-rays and they're normal and the pain continues no matter what you do, one of the things that should be evaluated is to see if you have one leg shorter than the other. So first of all, you have to have that evaluated. Now, one of the problems with this condition is that for the most part, experts are not very good at measuring it. They've actually done studies where they take what so-called experts, it might be a podiatrist and a physical therapist, orthopedist and other specialists, and have them all measure the same patient, and they all come up with different numbers. And part of the problem is it's just hard to measure externally what these differences are. Part of it is that clothes can get in the way. If you're heavy, that can the layer of fat can get in the way. And sometimes if this, you imagine this is my pelvis up here, my shoulders, is you get tilting of the pelvis this direction, and it makes it hard to tell what is actually a long bone and what is tilting of the pelvis. So studies show there's only one way to really evaluate this. This is to get a special type of x-ray called a scanogram. Here you have to be referred to a radiologist. They stand you up next to a wall with a grid, and then they measure the length of your femur, of your tibia, and the level of your pelvis, and they'll tell us exactly what the difference is. How much of it is truly structural, how much of it is functional. From there, we can make a decision how to treat it. Because for example, you may have one leg that looks long. Let's say your right leg looks long. And it may turn out it actually the left leg is structurally longer, but it's that tilt causing the appearance of the other leg being long. So the last thing you want to do is support the wrong foot or the wrong leg. So the way we treat this initially, once we figure out what the difference is to use some lifts inside the shoe to slowly bring you up. Now you can only do a little bit at a time, or muscles that will start to react and can develop pain from adding these lifts. So we put a little bit of lift, maybe on an arch support or an orthotic, but right under your heel, and we slowly build that up over a number of weeks, and we find out what's going to be most comfortable for you. Most patients don't tolerate more than about 80% of the difference between the two legs. So we build you up to as close as we can get to the point you're most comfortable, see how your symptoms react, and then if it's a small amount, we can just leave that in the shoe. If it's a larger amount, we may need to write a prescription to add that to the exterior of the shoe. So if you're having any of these symptoms, or you think you might have a leg that is shorter than the other, find a podiatrist in your area who specializes in biomechanics and sports medicine and see them. If you are in our area, make an appointment to see us, and you can find some more information on this on our website.